I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
From Arizona's number one high school, this is Desert Vista Thunder Television.
Today on this Friday, November 18, 2011, those big boxes by the bottom of the stairs are waiting for cans from you. Junior Cooper Gardner did his part this morning by bringing in a bag full. Way to lead the way. I'm Brooke Sirach. Thank you for joining us. This is DVTV. We apologize for the technical difficulties earlier this week. We want to make sure you guys don't miss anything, so our show will be a little bit longer today. The DV Can Food Drive has started this year, and the hopes are to fill those boxes up. Remember, the winning third hour class gets a pizza party. This video was put together for us 2 years ago, but it gets the idea across.
Dude, where's our pizza?
I don't know. It's supposed to be here 5 minutes ago.
It's ridiculous.
Contribute to this great cause and your third hour could win a pizza party. The class with the most cans will also receive the Spirit Cup. So bring in those cans, DV. Congratulations to senior Julia Thatcher, who has been selected as Desert Vista's nominee for the ASU Leadership Scholarship. Julia now continues in the competition for a $36,000 scholarship. Good luck, Julia. Battle of the Bands was a big success last night as DV's finest bands, rappers, and solo artists rocked the courtyard. Take a listen.
The acts that participated in this event were truly amazing. Student Council hosted a great Battle of the Bands this year. Here are some of the contestants.
Night.
Everyone tried their hardest, but there could only be three. Here were the winners.
Winning was fantastic. To prepare, I pretty much just sat in my closet all day and kind of just sang. It was whatever, but yeah. The end.
Today I don't feel like doing anything.
Well, I'm happy that I won second place. I got 2 gift cards to AMC. I'm really happy. It's my pride and my passion, and I wish to do it forever in my life. I only practiced yesterday at night.
Yeah, winning feels cool. You know, my boy Josh over here, he came up to me after a football game that we won. Go check us out at Mesquite High School actually tomorrow night, 7 p.m. Anyways, yeah, we're doing this song called Be My Girl. Pretty sure that's what it's called. Studio version comes out in a week, so check that out. Probably on iTunes or SoundCloud. Yeah, it feels good to win.
This is Gabby Newell for DVTV.
Thank you, Gabby. The event was a great success for Student Council as they were able to raise a lot of money. Congratulations to the three winners and great job to everyone else. DV Marching Band has had a great season this year, including their second state championship win in a row. Our first year class found out a little more about one important member of our band, Lauren Scott. Check this out.
Music takes talent, and Scotty has it. Lauren Scott, or Scotty as she is known by her friends, is a member of the Desert Vista Band. She has been playing in the Desert Vista Band for all 4 years of high school.
I started playing in the band because I wanted to continue on with music from middle school. And, you know, I joined marching band. It was something that really interested me in eighth grade, and I really wanted to do that. I play flute with the wind ensemble, which is the school's top ensemble, and then I play oboe in symphonic band, and I'm the drum major for the marching band, so I conduct.
She's shown improvement every year, and that's such a neat thing to be around students like that, that work hard and give of their time and energy to improve in everything that they do, to redefine excellence, and she has been a real example of that.
When her time at DV is up, Lauren hopes to continue playing in the marching band at ASU. At ASU, Lauren will major in music. She also wants to start teaching private music lessons. Scotty hopes that all this will result in some sort of career in music in the future. For DVTV, I'm Chase Bokey.
Thank you, Chase Bokey and team. Although the band season has ended, their Winter Guard season has just begun. The award-winning Desert Vista Winter Guard is holding a clinic next week for anyone interested in the upcoming competitive season. The clinics are next Monday and Tuesday from 6 to 9 p.m. Good luck to the DV Cheer Competition team as they compete in the AIA State Championship on Saturday at Estrella Foothills High School. The Desert Vista Literary Magazine and Creative Writing Clubs are hosting The Feast, an open mic music and poetry reading night. Come check it out in the Black Box Theater Monday night at 6:15. The entry will cost $2. Proceeds will go to the publication of the DV Literary Magazine and Mission Remission in support of those suffering from colorectal cancer. Come support DV 5A Hockey this weekend as they compete twice. On Saturday, they play Brophy at 12:30 at the Jobbing.com Arena. And on Sunday, they take on Desert Ridge at Arcadia Ice Arena at 5:40. Dry land has started for all hockey players interested in improving their endurance and skills. If you are interested, meet in Ms. Go's room E112 at 4:45 on Mondays. Grad Night is having a garage sale this Saturday at 16036 South 30th Place, one block north of DV. If you have items to donate or are able to work, please contact Barbara Ellery. It's going to be a short week next week as we all get excited for a four-day weekend and the start of the holidays. But don't forget, school rules still apply. We have a little reminder for you about why you should mind the policies and put your phones away.
Fiddle devil, baby! You're gonna use your phone three times before school, at lunch.
joking aside, DV's technology policy is still taken very seriously. Keep phones off and away until lunch or after school. So now, let's go to the week in rap. It's time for Flocabulary.
Listen. Occupy Wall Street, got the boot. They got kicked out when 5-0 came through. Zuccotti Park got clean like it's brand new. Now some dudes are behind bars like a zoo. Syria got told it's not cool to kill protesters. That's what it shouldn't do. Syria, you have legitimate haters. Not just the West, now your Arab neighbors. The NBA, you'll get sued by the players. It's all about power, right, Darth Vader? Did you hear about the M.A. Mayor? 22 years old, wow, that's major. This grad will run his hometown. He got the most votes, that's how it goes down. But if you wanna go up and wanna fly NASA, well, you're out of luck. NASA has no more shuttles. So to get up to space on the double, they asked Russia for a ride. Success, I see you cosmonauts on the other side. Some in the Midwest have been stressed about the pipeline that would've run right by them and maybe mess with the water supply. The pipeline's moving, y'all can wave it bye-bye. Obama wants to get specific and boost trade across the Pacific. He toured Asia, and if you missed it, our troops will be in Australia to visit. No, to stay, and that's kinda a way for us to keep an eye on China. The GOP debate, what did we see? Kane wasn't able to maintain a lead. Those who find Rob Pattison dreamy, camped out for twilight and tents and teepees. We dream a lot, but we're never sleepy. Wait a week and we'll be back on your TV.
In other national news, via the New York Times, GOP candidate Herman Cain is getting added attention. He has become the first Republican presidential candidate to now receive Secret Service protection. Then, candidate Senator Barack Obama did as well when he was a presidential candidate. 2 weeks ago, sexual molestation charges against Penn State assistant football coach Jerry Sandusky. And now, allegations of sexual molestation are surfacing for another coach in New York. As reported yesterday on ESPN, assistant basketball coach at Syracuse University, Bernie Fine, is now being accused of molesting a man by the name of Bobby Davis, starting back in 1984 and not ending until Bobby was almost 27 years old. And now a second alleged victim, Mike Lang, Bobby Davis's stepbrother, is reporting similar allegations against Bernie Fine. Bernie is currently on administrative leave until these reports are solved by investigators. And finally, to some entertainment news, the Associated Press reports that Demi Moore has announced her wish to divorce husband Ashton Kutcher. They have been married since 2005. Well, at least they lasted longer than the 72-day marriage of Chris Humphries and Kim Kardashian. If you happen to miss anything on our show today, just go online to dvthundermedia.com, DV School Fusion website, or you can even find us on Facebook. Just search Desert Vista Thunder Media. Have a great day, Thunder, and we'll see you at the game tonight.